वेलकम टू द लेक्चर कोर्स CHO 351 स्ट्रक्चर डिटरमिनेशन बार्गेनिंग कंपाउंड बाय स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिक मेथड. सो इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंट स्पिन सिस्टम इन 1H NMR. सो NMR स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिस्ट डेवलप द शॉर्ट हैंड नोटेशन called as the Popol notation. So called Popol notation. So this notation is convenient to us. So because of this, spectroscopist developed this notation. So in this notation method, we are use the alphabets. We use the capital alphabets A, B, C to up to X, Y, Z. So in this notation system, when in 1H NMR, the proton So, in our proton system, there are two proton of one type. That time we are use this kind of subscript, like that is A2. Or B3 means there are three protons of one type. Means we are use this type of notation. Also, when in 1H NMR, two protons have the similar chemical shift value. Similar means close chemical shift value. That time we are use the alphabets that is close to one another. That is close to one another. That is the A B. A B spin system is nothing but proton H A is present, proton H B is present that have the close chemical shift value means that give the first order spectra. Sorry, that give the second order spectra, that is the delta nu. This is difference is a small here. Also, in this system, we are use the AX system. AX system is nothing but, means we are use the letter ABC versus XYZ. Means when protons have the large difference in chemical shift value, that time we are use the ABC versus XYZ, means we are right here AX system, means proton HA and proton HX. So there is a large difference in chemical shift value, wide difference in chemical shift value. So this is the first order spectra, so delta nu is large here. So this gives rise to the first order spectra. Also, when in our system there are three protons and these three protons have the different chemical shift value, so at that time we are visually use the letter M. So middle of the alphabet we are use this letter M. So in AMX system, proton HA, proton HM and proton HX. So they have the different chemical shift value. Also ABC. So in this system, ABC spin system, proton HA, HB and HC. So they have the close chemical shift value. So this gives rise to the second order spectra. Also in spin system, sometimes protons are chemical and magnetical equivalent, means protons are chemical equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. That time we are using this kind of notation AA dash, means the protons are chemical, means here one proton, that protons in this system chemical equivalent or chemical equivalent and magnetically non-equivalent. So we are with the AA dash type of notation. So in this system we are use the this kind of notation, that is the A2, B3, AB, AX, MX, ABC, AA dash. So we are going to learn here some different spin system in this lecture. So one by one. So firstly, we are going to learn two proton coupled system, means in this system only two protons couple, means you are called two proton coupled system. And in this system, firstly we take the A2 system. A2 system is nothing but in our system the protons present two and that are chemical and magnetical equivalent. So obviously we are saying that here we can say that it is a delta nu difference, for this is zero, and because of that in this system we are get the single absorption peak, because of proton have the same chemical shift value, means delta nu is zero here. So this is the first system we are observed in two proton coupled system. Next is the AX system. So in AX system the proton HA and HX, so this difference in chemical shift value for these two proton is large here, large chemical difference. So delta nu by J, so this ratio obviously become larger here. So in this system generally delta nu is very large than coupling constant. So the proton HA split into the doublet because of proton HX, and also HX proton split into doublet. So we get the two doublets in this system. So these are because of proton HA and these are because of suppose HX. So we are observed the large difference in chemical shift value here, delta nu. So in this type of system, AX system, this gives rise to the first order spectra that can be interpreted by the N+1 rule. You know very well. Last time I am already told these things. So this kind of first order spectra actually follow Pascal triangle ratio, means we get the doublet here, that doublet follow Pascal triangle ratio in AX system. Next is the AB system. So in this system also the proton HA, that is the proton HA and proton HB, they have the very close chemical shift value, so delta nu difference is very small here. Obviously delta nu by J, this ratio is a small that approach to unity, so this value also becomes small. So these two protons are strongly coupled to each other, means we are of the strongly coupled situation in this system. So proton HA coupled with HB give doublet, proton HB coupled with HA give doublet. So we get the two doublets. So we get this kind of signal, HA proton give doublet, HB give the doublet. But this doublet not follow Pascal triangle ratio. So intensity of the peak is not according to Pascal triangle ratio, 1:1. So here this is the inner peak, this two in the doublet, this inner peaks, this inner peak gets enlarged because of small difference in chemical shift, means this peak gets enlarged and outer peak is decreases here. Outer peak is decreases in AB system. Means you have observed the spectra, it is the second order spectra that cannot be interpreted by the n plus 1 rule. So this is about the two photon coupled system. Next is the three proton coupled system. In this we are firstly going to talk about AMX system. So last time we have seen the one example of styrene oxide compound. The styrene oxide compound 1H NMR spectra is nothing but AMX system pattern. So in this system there are proton, there are three type of proton, that is the HA, HM and HX. So they have the different chemical shift value. So difference in chemical shift value, HA, HM is large here, also HM, HX is large here. Means they have the different chemical shift value. All the three protons have the different chemical shift value in AMX system. So in this system, obviously delta nu is large here, and this delta nu by J ratio is also large here, and this system actually give the first order spectra. That spectra is interpreted by the n plus 1 rule, you know very well. And in this system each proton gives the four line to us, means overall we are observing 12 lines in this AMX systems. So each proton give the four lines. Last time we see the example of styrene oxide. So each proton produce the doublet of doublet. So 12 lines we are observed in the spectra of AMX system. So suppose HA proton firstly splitted by the, suppose we are considering any proton, but for our convenience suppose I take the HM proton. So HA coupled with HM proton means split into the doublet, and each doublet further splitted into the doublet and doublet by proton HX. So like this. So this proton give the how many lines? Four lines. So here we are observed the coupling constant, that is the JAM. This proton is coupled, proton HA and proton HM. Then AX means proton HA and HX couple. Then proton M and proton X is also coupled. So overall we are of the three coupling constant. Same way we can write for proton HM. Proton HM coupled with so splitted by the proton HA doublet. Again doublet is splitted by HX. So we get the four lines. Again HX proton splitted by HM, and again doublet is splitted by the proton HA. So overall we are observed the 12 lines in the spectra of AMX system. So this is the this kind of pattern is also observed in three proton coupled system. Next is the ABX system. So in this ABX system the proton HA, proton HB and proton HX. So these two protons have the close chemical shift value, but proton HA and HX, proton HB and HX. So we are observed the large difference in chemical shift value. Means these two protons are strongly coupled to each other, HA and HB, but proton HA coupled with HX or proton HB coupled with HX, we are observed the weak coupling between them. So in ABX system, So here also each proton gives the 4 peaks, means doublet of doublet. So overall 12 lines we are observed in the spectra of this compound. So proton HA coupled with HB gives the doublet. Again doublet is splitted by the proton HX, so we get the like this. We get the how many lines? 4 lines. So also HB is splitted by the proton HA, give the doublet. Again this doublet is splitted by the proton HX like this. So we get the again 4 lines. Proton HX splitted by proton HA, again proton B split the doublet, each line of doublet, so we get the overall 12 peaks in the spectra of this compound. So in this system, ABX system, we can take the example of para-chlorostyrene compound. So para-chlorostyrene, so this para-chlorostyrene, so this proton HA and HB have a close chemical shift field, but HX proton, so this somewhat shifted to downfield because of induced field of benzene ring. So this proton is deshielded. So in this compound we are observed the ABX pattern. So when we observe the spectra, so we get the spectra like this. So these are because of proton HX. These are because of proton HA, means overall 4 lines. And these are because of HB. So overall 12 lines. But here this peak, this is the inner peak gets enlarged, outer peak is decreases here, like AX system. So proton HA and proton HB, in that we are observed the this doublet and this doublet. These two doublets are clearly separate from each other here, because here JAB is small here, and because of that we are observed that they are clearly separate from each other here. And this also separate, this also separate. So this about the ABX system. Next is the ABC system. So in ABC system, the proton HA, proton HB and proton HC, these three protons HA, HB and HC, they have the close chemical shift value. So delta nu is small here, so delta nu by J is obviously, this ratio is also small, so we get the second order spectra. So in ABS system, again same like AMX, ABX, each proton gives the 4 lines, means doublet of doublet peak. So overall 12 lines were observed in ABC system also. So also same like above system, here there are 3 coupling constant. It is a JAB, then JBC and JAC, and there are 3 chemical shift value, means proton HA, HB and HC, there are 3 chemical shift value of these 3 protons. So for example, example of allyl bromide. So this compound, in 1H NMR spectra of this compound of allyl bromide have the ABS system splitting pattern. So in this system, we have observed the peaks, but that peaks are overlapping, means we get the multiplets, doublet of doublet, doublet of doublet, and doublet of doublet, but that peaks are overlapping here. So this is the first order spectra. Next system, that is the AX2 system in 3 proton coupled system, AX2 system. So in this system we have observed the two kind of proton, HA and HX. So these two protons are widely separated from each other in chemical shift, that is delta nu difference is large here. So delta nu by J is also here, ratio is also larger here. So there are two chemical shift. So two protons HA and proton HX. So proton HA give the triplet signal, and triplet we get according to Pascal triangle ratio, and proton HX give the doublet according to Pascal triangle ratio, 1:1 intensity ratio. So this spectra is the first order that can interpret by the n plus 1 rule, that is the AX2 system. Next is the AB2 system. So in AB2 system, the proton HA and proton HB have the different chemical shift value, but delta nu difference between the chemical shift value is a small here. So we get the second order spectra that cannot be interpreted by n plus 1 rule. So delta nu by J, this J ratio is also small here. So in this system, the proton HA give the triplet signal, and proton HB give the doublet. This is the proton HA and this is the proton HB. So proton HA give the triplet and proton HB give the doublet. So here again, because of close chemical shift value, inner peak gets enlarged, outer peak decreases here. Same for doublet also. So inner peak gets enlarged, outer peak decreases here. So Pascal triangle ratio is not followed by doublet and triplet here. So for example, so this is a 1,2,3 trisubstituted benzene compound. In this compound, this type of compound actually give the splitting pattern, that is AB2 splitting pattern. These two protons are chemically equivalent, also magnetically equivalent. So this proton of one type, B proton, and this is the HA proton. So this give the AB2 splitting pattern. So this about the 3 proton coupled system. Next is the 4 proton coupled system. So in 4 proton coupled system, first is the AA dash X X dash. We're going to take this example here. So in this example, there are HA, HA dash, HX and HX dash. So there are four kind of proton is present. So these two proton have the same chemical shift value, same chemical shift value. Here is also these two proton have the same chemical shift value. Means this proton are chemically equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. Same we can say about HX and HX dash. These two protons are chemically equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. So because of this, the proton HA can be coupled with HA dash, coupled with HX, and can be coupled with HX dash. So overall, each proton gives the six lines here, and there are four protons, so 6 into 4, so overall 24 lines are observed in this spectra of this system. So firstly, the proton HA coupled with HA dash, so we get the doublet signal. Proton HA coupled with HX gives a doublet. Proton HA coupled with HX dash, doublet. So overall 6 lines because of each proton. So we are observed two coupling constant, sorry, we are observed two chemical shift value, and each proton when coupled with other proton, there are three coupling constant, means JA dash, then JAX, then JX dash, like this. So also A dash proton coupled with HA proton doublet, again HA dash proton coupled with HX doublet, HA dash proton coupled with HX dash, that is the doublet. So overall 6 lines. So again here we observe the three coupling constant. So each proton gives 6 lines and three coupling constant we are observed here for each proton. So overall we are observed the 24 lines in the spectra of this compound. So protons are chemically equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. So our spectra become quite complicated here because of proton are chemically equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. So in this spectra, the portion that is the A dash, this gives rise to the 10 lines, and the portion X and X dash, this gives rise to the 10 lines. So overall we are only observed 20 lines. So 4 lines actually we are not observed in the spectra of this system. That is A dash, X, X dash. So next is the next system here. It is A dash, B, B dash. So here is also observed the same kind of situation. But here in first system, we are observed the large difference in chemical shift value, means delta nu is larger in first case. But in second case, A dash, B, B dash, obviously it is the proton HA and proton HB or HA dash or HB dash. So there are two chemical shift value, but difference in chemical shift value is small here. So delta nu is small, so delta nu by J is small. So these two protons are strongly coupled, but proton HA and proton HA dash, they are chemically equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. Same way proton HB and HB dash, they are chemically equivalent but magnetically non-equivalent. So same like above case, that is the proton HA gives rise to 6 lines, proton HB gives rise to 6 lines, HA dash gives rise to the 6 lines, HB dash gives rise to 6 lines. Overall 24 lines we are observed in the spectra of this compound, 24 lines. So this kind of spectra become quite complicated, quite means more complicated here, because we are observed the very close chemical shift value in the A dash, B dash system. So small chemical shift difference, So this about the four proton coupled system. So this all about the different spin system present in 1H NMR.